The definition just is same as it is a user defined data types, because now user can collect the multiple data items. But in case of array, it is a derived data type. Clear? So the structure is a user defined data type that combines the multiple, or we can say that different types of data together. And see here the advantages using structures. First is you can construct, you can create any of the complex data type using structure. Second, as I told earlier, it combines the dissimilar data item together. And the last one is what, when you are creating any of the structures, you can use that structure multiple time in a different structure also, using just declaring its variable. Clear? So now move to the first part, defining a structure. So how we can define the structures? For that we have to follow the syntax, like struct keyword first, that indicates the structure, and then the structure name that depends on a user. It is similar to the function name, variable name. Suppose you want to create the structure for a student, then in that case your structure name will be student. Suppose you are writing for a book or for a employee, then the structure name will be changed. So inside this structure, start and stop curly bracket, we have to write the number of members. So first is a data type and then member one. So the data type is nothing but the integer float, like that. And the member, suppose I am considering student, then the student details, we can say members, like its roll number, name, address, birth date and much more. So data types and member one, data type member two, likewise that you can create any number of members. After that, we are discussing about one simple example of student. Here the struct keyword is there, and then the name of structure, that is student, and inside curly bracket we have to write the data type first and the member. So first member here is a roll number, and you guys aware of it, the roll number is always in an integer form, so the data type is int. The second is name. So for name, the string is there, number of characters. So here I am considering character array, that is for name, and the size is 10. That indicates the maximum 10 characters you can specify in your name. And the third one is character address. So in an address, the more numbers of characters are there. So I am considering the size 50. Clear? And then after closing brackets, we have to put semicolon. So whenever you are writing any of the program using structure, first step is you have to define the structure. Then we have to move onwards for a second step, that is declare the structure variable. Now, to declare the structure variable, there are two different methods. Here I am considering first method, and the syntax is with the defining structure. So first we have to follow the syntax of a defined structure, that is struct, structure name, and inside curly brackets the data type and members. And after curly bracket, you can write the number of variables and then semicolon. See here in an example, suppose same example I am considering for a student having roll number, name and address as a member. So in that case, suppose I want to store data of one student, then we have to declare only one variable. Suppose you want for a three students, then you need three variables for a student. So here I am considering S1, S2, S3, that means three students' data you can store. Clear? Now move to the second method, that is totally different, and that you have to write inside the void main. Clear? So the syntax is just like keyword struct, then structure name, and then the variables v1, v2 up to vn. Now just see the example, this method we have to use inside the void main, and whenever you are defining any of the structures, that you have to write before the void main. Clear? So before void main we are defining our structures. Let's see here in example, the struct student, and then inside curly brackets we are writing the three members, integer roll number, character name 10 and character address 50. And after defining these structures, we have to write the void main, and inside void main we have to follow the second method, that is struct, student and the three variables s1, s2 and s3. Clear? That indicates we can store three students' data into that particular structure student. So here the members are what? Roll number, name and address. So for accessing that members, we have to use the dot operators. Clear? How? Let's understand the same example I am considering, and for that we have to follow the syntax like structure variable, then we have to put the dot sign and then the structure members. So suppose my structure variable here is s1. So in example I am writing variable, that is s1, then dot and the first member, that is roll number. Likewise that you can write for a number of members. So s1.name is there, s1.address is there. Suppose you are taking three variables s1, s2 and s3 and you want to access the third student roll number, then you have to write s3.rollNumber. Clear? Likewise that you can use dot operator for accessing any members. Now move to the next part, that is initializations. How we can assign the value for each and every members. So for that initializations, always there are two different methods. First is a compile time and second is a runtime. In a compile time method, we can say like it is a fixed value that we can assign using equal to sign. And in a runtime method, we have to read the data from the user. Clear? So in a compile time initialization method, we have to write like struct, then structure name and variable name, suppose that is v1, equal to inside curly bracket the list of values and semicolon. Just see here the example. So first I am writing struct keyword, then structure name here is in example students, and then the variable for a only single students we want, so write s1 equal to. Now the list of values, for that you have to maintain the proper order that you are follow in your definition part. Clear? So in a definition of structures, we are writing first the roll number. So here you have to first write roll number, then name and then address. So the first here the roll number is like 1. Name is Bhavya. It is in a double inverted. Why? Because it is a number of characters, that is string. It is always in a double inverted. And then the address, simply I am putting Ahmedabad. Clear? So this is what, when you are executing the same program, you are finding the same value, that is roll number 1, name is Bhavya and third is Ahmedabad address. But this is correct? No. When we are creating any of the program, the data will be read from the user, and for that we have to use runtime initialization method, that is using scanf function. So in a scanf we are writing three control string. First for a roll number, that is percentage D, that indicates integer data type, then percentage S for a string, and again percentage S for a string, that is for address. And after that we have to use the variable, then dot and then member. So here I am writing and s1.rollNumber means the roll number value that user enter will be stored. Then second will be in a name, so s1.name and then s1.address. One thing you have to remember, in a scanf when your data type is string percentage s, that indicates you have to not write the and before the variables. Clear? Now let's see here one simple example, that write a program using structure to enter the roll number, name and address for a single students and print the same details. So how you can write the program? Our first step is define structure, second step is declare the variable, third step is access the member using dot operator, and the last one is initialize the value. This four theory you have to apply when you are creating any of the program using structure. And always the first step is include the header file. and then after we have to write the define structure before the void main. So here I am writing struct keyword, and for a student I am writing 3 members, roll number, name and address. Now after defining the structures, we have to declare the variables, and for that 2 methods are there. Here I am using which method? First, that means S1 variable for a single student. Now inside void main we have to write the message like printf enter roll number, name and address for a student 1. Then we have to read the data from the user using scanf function. So use the scanf function, and inside it we have to write percentage d for integer, percentages, and then first is a S1 dot roll number, second is a S1 dot name, and third is a S1 dot address. So 3 value will be read from the user, and then after we have to print the same data that user have entered, and for that we are using 3 different printf statements. In a first printf we are writing like slash n for a new line and slash t for a tab, and before that we are printing like the message student details. So here the dash line is there, and then we are printing student details. So this is one simple message will be displayed on our output screen, and then after the printf will work same slash n slash t, and then roll number equals percentage d, and then which value we want to print here, the s1 dot roll number, clear? Likewise that for a name we have to write percentage s because of string s1 dot name, and then the last one is address equals percentage s again, and then s1 dot address. So when we are executing this program, it starts from a void main, clear? And then the message will be printed on our output screen, that is enter roll number, name and address. And suppose I am entering roll number 10, name Bhavya and address Ahmedabad, then these 3 data will be stored in our variable S1, and then same data we are printing using last 3 printf statements. Then our output is just like in a tabular form, the student details, then roll number equals 10, name equals Bhavya and address equals Ahmedabad. Here I am considering only single program using structures. You can build any number of program using this concept. I hope you guys understand this concept very well. In our next video, we will see more about the array of structures and nested structures. If you have any query, feel free contact me. If you like this video, then thumbs up. If you think this video will help some of your friends, then do share this video with them. Also, you can subscribe my channel so when I upload new video, you get a notifications. Till then, bye.